bad luck. Oh. Well, it's no laughing matter. The first time I noticed that's when I met my third wife. Now, if that wasn't a warning... You fellas had better settle down and be serious. Something is going to happen.
Well, you won't meet any marrying females up. You're safe anyhow.
Quit talking about trouble. We're due at the pass now.
The other boys will guard the head of the pass. We'll wait for him at this end.
Come on,
okay.
Let's go.
I guess we've lost them.
Wait a minute, fellas! Here they go, over here! Come on! Yeah.
You ain't hit hard, are you, Wolf?
I reckon the old wolf is about through snapping.
It's only a scratch. There isn't a bullet made tough enough to enter your old hide.
Yes, that's what most of our kind think, son. Imagine we have charmed lives because most sheriffs are bad shots. But there's a bullet somewhere with our name on it, waiting for us.
Wolf! What's happened here?
The wolf's hit, Cookie.
We've got to get him out of here.
Save yourself, son. Never mind about me.
We're all leaving here together.
You and Cookie get going before it's too late. I'm through.
We're not leaving here without you.
Get him away, Cookie.
You're off your nut, Wolf. If you think I'd ever leave here without you.
Listen, son. You're riding out of here, and you're going to forget Wolf Hardy and his pack.
What are you talking about?
That bullet I stopped might have got you. The game ain't worth it. Go to some new country. Start over again. And go straight this time.
Go round up the horses, Cookie. I think we can get out through that end of the canyon.
What'd you do that for?
I hated to do it, Cookie. He wouldn't listen to reason. It's up to you, Cookie, to get him out of the Badlands and into new territory.
You're alive.
All right. Tell him the bullet finished me.
I understand. I reckon that's the only way. You're just in time for breakfast, Jim.
Well, what happened, Cookie? Where's Wolf?
The Wolf's taken his last trail, Jim.
You mean?
The posse got him.
I'll get the boys together and wipe out every last one of them.
No, you won't, Jim.
No? Who's gonna stop me?
I will. I promised the Wolf that I'd see that you'd go straight. And I'll do it if I have to fill you full of holes.
No, Cookie. You don't understand. I owe everything to him. He picked me up when I was a half-starved kid. Why, the least I
The least you can do is to respect his last wish. When he cashed in, Jim, his last thought was of you. He wanted you to go straight.
All right, Cookie. I guess you win.
Yes, to the new trail, Jim.
To the new trail.
There's your time, Blanco. Now I want you to get off this ranch and stay off.
What's the idea, Mr. Lanning? Wasn't my work satisfactory?
I've got no fault to find with your work. But I told you to stay away from my daughter. And you disregarded my wishes.
Well... Of course, if I'm not good enough to associate with your daughter.
That's enough, Blanco.
Hello, Judy. Wait a minute, I'll open the gate for you.
I just got paid off.
You mean?
Fired.
But why?
Well, I don't know. I guess your dad thinks I've been paying too much attention to his darling daughter.
Fathers are funny that way. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, too. I'd wanted you to attend that dance with me tonight.
I'd like to, but Dad wouldn't let me.
Why? It'll be all right. You have no cause for worry. My sister's going to be there. She'll take care of you.
Oh, it's no use. Dad...
He'll never know. Come on, be a sport. Maybe the last time I'll have a chance to be with you.
All right. I'll go.
Fine. Now listen. I'll meet you down there.
Like a pretty nice town.
Well, I don't care how nice it is, so the beds are soft.
Well, here's where we start rustling.
What?
For a new job.
Well, it's gonna be pretty tough to settle down to honest work.
We can get used to anything in time. I reckon your corn's hurting again, huh?
Yes, it did. You know what that means. Trouble.
Forget it.
Well, you know what happened the last time that corn hurt.
You're talking about. I know the wedding march when I play it.
Well, you should tell me. I paid the alimony in every state in the Union. You had it right in the first place.
Oh, yes, that's right.
Coming off, bartender?
A little wedding. A little cantina wedding.
Well, this is luck. An old pal of mine turns up.
Just now he's asleep.
See about a room, Jim.
All right.
Pretty good stuff, isn't it?
It certainly is. Yes, I'll have another.
Oh, waiter, two more.
There's pretty good country around here. Should be good picking.
You're talking to the wrong man, Blanco. I'm looking for a regular job.
You'd be satisfied with 40 a month, eh? Well, I think you're a sap.
Well, I'm the best judge of that.
Well, you know your own business.
How about the old days?
Well, don't worry. Just don't you do any talking. And I won't.
Fair enough, Blanco.
I hadn't seen you around before, but I've been away some time myself.
Who?
The boy's calling Blanco Kid.
Why, yes. Are you the other part of this cantina wedding?
Wedding?
Aren't you going to marry Blanco Kid?
Marry him? Why, no. I'm going to a dance with him.
My mistake. I must have you mixed up with somebody else.
Come on in the room, Jim.
Cooking? Blanco's up to something. Girl's been framed.
What makes you think that?
Well, I'm not much of a hand with women. But the way she spoke, she's ignorant of any marriage. She's expecting to go to a dance with Blanco.
Judy.
Where's your sister, Blanco? I thought you said she was coming here with you.
Oh, never mind about my sister. I've got a nice little surprise for you.
Surprise? What do you mean?
We're going to be married.
Why, don't be absurd, Blanco. I'm not going to marry you.
I said we're going to be married.
Did you hear that, Cookie? What did I tell you? Where are you going?
I'm going over to her. I got a hunch I might be needed.
Well, I've gone and made all preparations, and I'm not going to disappoint my friends. What are you doing putting in here?
I reckon the lady has something to say about who she's going to marry. Would you like me to see you home, ma'am?
Now, you stay out of it.
Thank you.
Pick him up now.
Took your girl, Blanco.
Yes, he won this deal, but the game's just starting.
So, you did disobey me and go to this dance.
I'm sorry, Dad. But I guess you were right about Blanco Kid.
Did you have trouble with him in town?
Yes. But these two gentlemen interfered and brought me home.
Well, it looks to me as if we owed these gentlemen a vote of thanks.
Well, you could thank us with a couple of jobs.
Oh, looking for work, eh?
Yes, sir.
There's something like.
Did you ever handle much stock?
Why, yes. We've handled plenty of people's stock.
Oh, yes. Often.
Well, I just let my foreman go. I wonder if you could fill his boots.
Well, I'm sure of it.
You're hired. Come on, I'll show you where you can bunk.
Boys. Well, have a good night's rest, and I'll see you at daybreak.
Don't mention it.
What do you want to do? Spoil everything?
Well, imagine that old buzzard telling us to come in here and get a good night's rest and get up at daybreak. Why, it's 4 o'clock now. Well, I am glad, but then I'm used to something light. Keep that light out so we can get a little rest.
Daybreak.
She sure is a great girl.
Well, I see you're nicely settled around here.
Oh, you know you're not welcome on this range.
I know that. But you see, I got a little deal on, and I'll need your help.
I'm not interested.
No? Oh, I think you will be. It's my eye on Lanning's cattle for a long while. That's why I kind of shined up to his daughter. But since I'm not standing so well with Miss Judy, I'll need you.
You've said enough, Blanco.
Oh, yes? Well, now you listen to me. Either you come in with me, or I'm going to tell Lanning just who you really are. Why, how do you do, Miss Judy?
You'd better get going, Blanco.
Don't forget what I told you. You can find me at the cantina in town.
Blanco kid certainly had his nerve coming here.
I don't think we'll be bothered with him anymore.
How's everything going?
Oh, fine. But I think Cookie and I'll be drifting pretty soon.
Why? Don't you like it here?
It isn't that. We're so used to being on the move. It's kind of hard to stay in one place very long.
I'd hate to see you leave. Maybe you'll change your mind.
Jim, was that on the level about us drifting?
I'm afraid so, Cookie. We may as well get going before Blanco starts talking.
Would it hurt a feller's conscience to kill a rattler?
Meaning what?
Thought I could mosey into town and have a little confab with the kid.
Forget it, Cookie. I appreciate you wanting to take the job off my hands. But after all, that's my job.
Okay.
What's that you say? Members of the Wolf Hardy gang? How do you know this? Say, who is this talking? Hello. 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 Oh, Judy, it looks like as if we had been taken in aplenty.
What do you mean, Dad?
Those buckaroos of yours seem to be outlaws from a notorious gang up north.
Who told you that?
I don't know. But it sounded very much like the Blanco kid's voice.
The kid would do something like that, just to get even with the boys for helping me.
I think I'll have a talk with them anyway.
Dad, remember what they did for me.
Yeah. Maybe I won't talk to him right now. But I'll keep my eye on him just the same.
I know it's tough, Jim, but it just ain't in the cards. Let's be drifting.
Yeah. That's all we'll ever be doing. Drifting. I reckon a fella just can't put the old trail behind him.
It's that Blanco's doings. I'd like to choke his rotten neck.
us on the north range.
Well, you go around with the boys. We'll go on ahead.
Hey, roll out of your bunk. Russell's on the north range.
Well, why don't you go after him?
Hurry up, you lazy Hurtis. How about your pants?
Oh, we don't need any pants. It's
come on, dark your pants.
Oh, wow.
Cookie told me you were dead.
I told him to tell you that. It was the only way I could get you to leave me.
Well, Wolf, I'm going it straight like you wanted me to. I got a regular job now.
I'm mighty glad of that, Jim.
What brought you down here?
A Blanco kid. He tipped off the sheriff about us up north.
The Blanco kid? Well, I saw him downtown.
You did? Well, here's where we have a showdown.
Look. Beat it, Wolf. I'll take care of them.
Pick him up, Wolf, and keep him up. Now get going.
You fellas just hold that picture.
Captured the Wolf and his gang, but that new man you hired, Jim, helped him to get away.
Then he's one of the Wolf's gang?
Well, it looks that way.
You ride into town and tell the sheriff.
All right.
Honey. It looks as if the Blanco kid was right.
Dad, I can't believe it.
I don't want to.
Sheriff, Wolf Harding's gang made a raid on Lanning's ranch last night.
Did you boys corral any of them?
Not yet, but they're out after them.
You wait here. I'll get my horse.
Now listen, fellas. This is our big chance. The cowboys of the Lanning Ranch are out looking for the wolf. Here's where we make our cleanup and get out of the country.
Yeah? How about the sheriff?
Don't worry about the sheriff. I just saw him outside. Well, we got clear sailing. Come on, let's get to going.
I didn't mean to come back.
Jim, can you walk? Please try. It's only a little ways. Hurt.
I'm awfully sorry to be so much trouble.
Cookie? I'm afraid I've spoiled Jim's chances by coming into this territory. I never suspected he was in these parts. I was only trailing the Blanco Kid. Did you get a line on the Blanco Kid?
Yeah. I saw him in the saloon. I heard him say he's headed for the girl's ranch.
Cookie, that's where we are headed for.
I'm mighty grateful to you for not turning me over to the sheriff.
You helped me once, and I suppose we have to repay a debt, even to a rustler.
Before I go, there's one thing you must believe. I didn't come here as a spy or a rustler. I only wanted a chance to begin over again.
Judy! For over an hour. Where have you been?
Well, I just went over to the corral. See if any of the boys has returned.
Those rustlers must be giving them a terrible chase. I was just talking to the sheriff.
He's liable to be here at any minute now, so better come in and have a breakfast.
Slim, you come with me. Trace, stay here and watch the road.
What's the matter with you, Judy? You've been acting so strangely lately.
Why?
You seem to have something on your mind.
Oh, it's nothing.
All right, let's go have breakfast.
Good morning, Lanning. Take it easy, Lanning. I came after something that's in that safe. The payroll.
That safe is empty.
Now, you listen to me. I don't like you any too well. You get over there and do as I say, or I'll...
Try.
Come on in here, Slim. Go on over there and get that payroll.
Shot came from the house, Cookie.
What's going on here?
Wait a minute, Sheriff.
What's happened, Lanning?
here just in time to arrest this Blanco kid. And those two fellas, they tried to hold me up for the payroll.
Take charge of him.
Wait a minute, Sheriff.
You've heard of Wolf Hardy and his gang, haven't you?
Yes.
Well, there's the Wolf. Fella, here's his cop. And that old fogey you see over there is another member of his gang.
Well, I guess I've rounded up the whole gang.
Sheriff, I want a word with you.
All right.
Well, you know, Lanning, you can't arrest a man unless you prefer charges.
That's just exactly what I thought, Sheriff.
Yes, of course. Well, I...
Take the kid along. Go on.
Wolf, border's only a few miles from here. You and your gang should get across before I could meet up with you. I couldn't bring you back.
Much obliged, Sheriff.
It's all right.
Thanks, Lanning.
You're welcome.
I'm mighty grateful too, sir. Jim.
Dad, don't let him go.
Jim.
Cookie, don't forget, we start on the roundup in the morning.
La gran bailarina de rumba, que se ha ganado el aplauso del pueblo mexicano en general, señorita Mariquita del Mar.
Thank you.
I hear Dan Ward's heading back for Yellow Creek.
Well, I reckon what he ran away from has been straightened out.
What are you getting at, Duke?
He ain't fooling anybody. If he's not a wanted man, why has he been hanging around the border for 2 years?
For his father's health, he says. But he ain't got that excuse no longer. If the truth was known, I'll bet the old buzzard died of lead poisoning. If you ask me, Dan Ward and his father was both outlaws. No need to ask you, Farrell. Here's Dan. Why not ask him? You're taking back what you just said, Farrell, or I'm putting the brand of a liar on you. I reckon that goes as I played it, Ward.
God, Dan!
Get excited, partner. Your turn's next.
Get up. And keep going till I can't even hear your echo. Are you back in Farrell's play?
Well, I wasn't in on that play. They were his chips, and you cashed them for him. You know, Dan, I was always your pal.
You're too close to Farrell to be any friend of mine.
Because that's the way you feel about it.
That's that.
Yeah, that's what old Yakima said when he grabbed his wildcat with the tail. Dan, sure enough, are you going to pull up stakes?
Yeah. Since Dad died, there's nothing to keep me here. Besides, I want to see the old town. I've still got some friends there in spite of all the foolish tricks I pulled.
One friend in particular. Hey, Dan?
Yep. She's still waiting for me. I wrote her a letter and told her to meet me outside of town. With what I got from the sale of our spread here, I aim to buy me a little ranch. Marry Molly and settle down.
If Jim Swain is still there, he might change your mind for you.
Swain won't stop me. I'm hoping to avoid trouble. But if he wants to keep that old quarrel alive, you'll find I can take care of my end of it.
I never knowed you to ride around trouble, and you sure can handle it when you meet it.
Why not come along, Jim? We could go shares.
Not me. With you getting married, three would be a crowd. No, Dan, that's your country. This is mine. I reckon we're better off sticking to our own. So soon?
I want to hit there before sundown tomorrow. I'll miss you, Jim.
That goes double for me, partner. If I was sure there's going to be a scrap, I'd trail along.
There won't be any if I can help it. Come on, partner.
So long, Dan.
Dan, it's Molly. Everything's all right. Dan.
Molly.
I've sure been away from you a long time, Molly.
It's been ages.
I've been thinking of you every day. I've got a lot of plans, and some of them will surprise you. Where's your horse?
Over there in the rocks.
the matter? You seem to be nervous.
What do you mean?
Well, you're trembling.
Just the excitement of meeting you, that's all. Dan, Jim Swain's in town.
So that's it. Well, we won't let him stop us from riding in.
He brought his whole gang with him.
What's he hanging around Yellow Creek for?
I don't know. He seems to be waiting for something or somebody. But the boys are behaving themselves, and the sheriff can't do a thing.
Is Bob Larman still sheriff?
Yeah, that old woman.
You're wrong there. He's no old woman.
We were talking about you the other day. He doesn't want you to come back. He's got enough trouble as it is now.
Plains in town, eh? I hope there won't be any trouble.
You mean you're not going to do anything about it? After you and him have been enemies for years?
I suppose I'll have to someday, but I don't aim to go looking for trouble.
You're not talking like yourself, Dan. Not getting soft, are you?
No. Just getting tired of the kind of life I've been leading. Never got me anything.
Got you a reputation. Other men certainly step high, wide, and handsome when you're around.
I'm settling down, Molly. What do you say you and I get married right off?
You're certainly sure of yourself, aren't you? You come riding back here expecting to pick up just where you left off.
Are you trying to pretend there's another man?
Suppose there is.
Then I'll have to tend to him, I reckon. I mean it, Molly. I'm through with fighting and shooting scrapes. You and I are going to live decent and peaceable. My dad rode the hills, and so did yours. And they spent their lives dodging sheriffs and posses.
Yes, and they were men.
We'll talk it over on the way to Yellow Creek.
Stand aside, Ward, and take it.
Hiding behind a woman's skirts, huh? Well, stand aside and take your medicine.
Ted Wells, Molly. One of Swain's men. Molly!
I don't know what I can do for you, Mr. Pember. One of my deputies is laid up with a busted leg. The other is over to the Capitol on business. Dan Ward.
That's right, Sheriff.
Sit down. Well, what have you done now?
A man tried to ambush me near Mustang Canyon.
I'm not surprised at that, considering the enemies you made before you left here. Look out he don't try it again.
He won't.
Why not?
He's dead.
You shot him?
In self-defense.
That's what you say. Tell me about it.
What's the matter?
Dan Ward's back. He just shot Ted Wells.
Where is he now?
At the sheriff's.
I'll tell Swain. You keep out of the way.
Huh?
That's what happened.
Why should I go gunning for a man like Ted Wells?
Just what I've been asking myself. Unless it's because he's one of Swain's men.
When I want to settle with Swain, I'll go after him personally. Not pick on one of his men.
Anybody know you were coming?
Yeah. We won't go into that.
You can talk safe here, Dan. Mr. Pember's my personal friend. Owns the mines over to Rockville.
I've said all I'm going to.
Molly Clark mentioned you to me the other day. Did she know you were coming?
Yeah. I wrote to her. Told her to meet me near Mustang Canyon and tell me who was in town.
Just where you shot Ted Wells.
If you're meaning that you think I've lied...
Oh, it ain't that, Dan. I could tell you a lot. But I don't want you starting on the warpath.
There he is, Swain, just like I told you.
It's Wells, all right.
Come on, let's settle this.
That's right. We ain't letting Dan Ward get away with this.
You ain't going to run wild over my county. I've known you from a boy. You got outlaw blood in you, and...
No sheriff has got a thing on me. I have been wild, but I've never done anybody any lasting harm. I came back here to settle down, to put an end to the wards being outlaws, and run into something like this.
Did your plan of settling down include marrying Molly Clark?
Maybe.
I'm going to tell you some things, but I don't want you to fly off the handle.
I'd sure admire to know what you're driving at.
He's in there, Swain.
Step into that room, kid.
There ain't gonna be any gunplay, Dan.
This is my fight, Sheriff.
There ain't gonna be any fight. You say you don't want trouble? Now prove it by handing me that gun. Stay where you are, Swain. And don't make no bad moves. I've disarmed Ward, and
that suits me. I'm not here to make war. I know what happened to Wells, and I got something to say about it.
All the talk you can make won't change the facts any. He tried to ambush me, and I got him.
I know it, and I don't blame you. I don't shoot from ambush, and I don't send my men to do it. Anytime I want you, Ward, I'll come after you myself.
You'll find me waiting.
You take my word for it that I didn't send him?
Yes. But I'd like to know how he found out I was coming.
You'll learn soon enough. I'll be seeing you.
Anytime, Swain.
It'll be soon. There ain't enough air around here for both of us.
See here, Swain.
Get him over there. Take care of his horse and saddle.
I can't understand this thing at all. You hinted at something, and so did Jim Swain. Why did Wells ambush me?
To do somebody a favor.
Who?
Molly Clark.
What do you mean?
It's the truth, Dan. Molly doesn't love you. Never did. She's crazy about Bert Gilmore. And she was afraid you'd gun for him when you found out about it. So it's my guess that she takes Ted Wells into her confidence and...
You mean she planned to have Wells plug me?
What else is there to think, Dan?
I suspicioned something when she left so hurriedly. But somehow I just couldn't believe it.
We're going after Bert Gilmore?
I'll give him an even break.
Going gunning for him because he beat your time with a girl. That's kid stuff, Dan. It's my bet that Gilmore don't know any more about it than Swain. Molly Clark's the guilty one, and you can't go gunning for a woman.
About the matter we were discussing when Ward came in. I've found my man.
Good. Anybody I'll have to send for?
No. He's right here.
You're crazy. What's this all about?
You know my mine's near Rockville, on the other side of the range? Well, we've been running a railroad spur from Rockville to the mines. There's a gang of men there waiting for their pay. I've got the money here because the bank in Rockville was closed. Now you know why Swain and his men are hanging around town. Swain's got it in for me because I've got money. He'd like to get that payroll, or at least keep me from getting it through. And then trouble would start in Rockville.
Why don't you get somebody to take it?
I've tried, but I haven't been able to find a clever, honest man to take the risk. It's my idea one man should do it. He would stand a better chance of getting through, for Swain has a big gang.
That's what I was thinking.
The man that tackles it will have a job. Swain will be trailing him every foot of the way. The payroll is $10,000. If I give it to you, will you take it through for me?
I tell you, you're crazy, Pember. Ward's got outlaw blood in him. You'd never see your money again. This is my chance, Sheriff, to prove that I'm not an outlaw. You can't make it, Dan, even if you mean to. Swain's after you already. I'll get your money through for you, Mr. Pember.
I want your word of honor that you won't let any personal matter interfere with this deal.
You've got it.
Sit down. We'll make our plans. Now, you better start about dawn, when things are quiet.
Oh, hang Swain anyway. I know what he's planning, yet I can't lay a hand on him. If he'd only give me an excuse to toss him into jail.
Seen Red?
Hasn't shown up yet, Swain. Sit down.
Have you located Pember again?
Must have ducked into another room at the sheriff's office when you went in.
Where is he now?
Still there. Him and the sheriff and Dan Ward sitting close talking.
Get back there. Keep your eyes and ears open.
I also want you to take a letter to my kid sister. She's a nurse at the mines. I'll go home and write it now and bring the money back here.
Neither is the light, but leave the front door unlocked. We better play it safe.
I'll see to my horse and then have a look around.
You better lay low till it's time to leave.
Well, that'd be playing right into their hands. If I show myself, they'll never suspect what's going on.
Dan's right. But you're not forgetting your promise to keep out of shooting scrapes until this job is finished.
I've given my word on that. It's all settled.
Trusting an outlaw with $10,000.
If anyone can do it, Ward can. He's got to fight outlaws. And who knows their tricks better? I am trusting him.
You're a smart hombre, all right, Bert. Letting Wells fight all your battles for you.
And look at what happened to him.
Why, you...
Sit down. Sure, sit down, Bert. What's the matter? Can't you take a little joke?
That's no joke to me. Do I want folks to think I'm afraid of Dan Ward? Well, I'll show you that I'm not afraid of him.
Ward.
Howdy, boys.
That's you, Dan.
Hello, Dan.
How are you, Mike?
You learned how to drink yet?
No. I still like my ginger ale.
Bert must have missed him.
No worry. He'll catch up with him.
Ted Wells was a friend of mine. I said Ted Wells was a friend of mine.
I reckon he was.
And you murdered him.
The sheriff doesn't think so.
Maybe you think I'm afraid to fight my own battles.
You don't act that way now.
Well, I'm staying in this town, Ward. And that means you're going. Now, when do you start?
You're all hot about something, Gilmore. There isn't any sense in us having trouble.
Ward, backing down.
Go! Or do you want me to shoot you down like you did Ted Wells?
What are you trying to do? Get us all thrown into the hoosegow?
I've got things to settle with him.
Not with a gun, you don't. With the sheriff waiting to jail us all.
I don't need a gun.
And I hope he does.
Get that girl and Gilmore out of here. They've caused enough trouble for tonight.
Fair enough, Swain. I wasn't hankering for a shooting scrape just now.
Neither was I. I got a little job to handle first. Then we're leaving things up. What do you say to a couple of days from now?
That's a date.
Saving Ward for yourself, eh?
Right. I know something now that I only suspicioned before. Ward is going to try and get that money through for Pemba. That's what they were talking about at the sheriff's. And that's why I saved them. To get the money from him. Red, you hightail it and find the boys. We'll cover the country between here and Rockville like a blanket. And no matter where Ward tries to get through, we'll get him.
guards are coming.
Circle around so he can't get through the gap. Now get going.
Heading for the narrows.
We'll get him from behind. Where is he?
I don't know. He's just ahead of us.
We just got to flash him. He's hiding around here somewhere. Come on, let's have a look.
Hey, boys, you must have got out here. It's the only way. Come on.
Can't get him now. Flash Swain, he's taking the south trail. He'll be waiting for a signal.
That signal means he's taken the south trail. We'll get him on the grade a mile out of Rockville. That is, if he lasts that long. Come on.
We want our pay, Sanderson. We've waited long enough. I can't hold them back much longer. Wait a minute, men. I haven't got your money yet. Mr. Pember will send it as soon as he can.
He's a crook. He don't tend to pay.
Men! My brother is not a crook. He has always been honest with you. He'll get your money through when he can.
Wait a minute, boys. Wait a minute. Promises don't pay for rent and food. You better get away, Miss Pember, before trouble starts.
I'm going to stay right here. You men don't realize what you're doing.
We are doing all right. We want to get it.
Take the cover. Can you win this time, Swain?
I always win, Ward. Butch, get into that saddlebag.
Get down after it.
I've got what I wanted, Ward. And I'm getting you the next time we meet.
Fair enough.
Look at it first.
Just nothing but blank paper.
And I let him go.
But he can't get away with this. Now listen, fellas. I'll tell you what we'll do.
Why, you men ain't gonna be a lot of crazy fools. You ain't gonna listen to what that silly girl has to say, are you? I tell you, they got the money in that office.
No use. They've determined to raid the office. And I'm just as determined they'll not. Let's not have any bloodshed, Sanderson.
So I say let's get it. And let's get it now.
You guys stop or I'll fire.
Come on, boys. I'm from Pember. I've got your money. You hear that? He's got your money.
Oh, he's got the money, has he? Let's make him show it to us. Yeah. Show it to us, have you? Let's make him show it to us. Yeah.
Here it is, boys. Hey.
Yeah.
There's real money. Your money'd have been here days ago. But Pember couldn't send it to you because Swain and his gang of thugs were waiting to grab it.
Jim Swain, hey? Well,
we'll get him.
We're thanking you, stranger, for bringing our money. Now, you fellas line up at the pay window. Come on in. We're going to get our pay, boys.
Jim Swain, eh? Why do they let such men run loose? There's only one worse in these parts, so I'm told. And that's Dan Ward. What's your name, by the way?
You just said it. Dan Ward.
Oh, you don't mean that.
That's my name.
Well, I'm sure sorry I spoke the way I did.
You better pay those men off before they start something else.
You're right.
Could you tell me where I could find Miss Pember?
Right there.
I have a letter for you from your brother.
Thanks. So you're the famous Dan Ward.
Don't you mean notorious?
Will you excuse me while I read this?
Why, certainly.
Here's a receipt for that money.
Wait till Bob Larman sees this. I'll make him eat it.
My brother's wife is ill. I ought to go to Yellow Creek at once.
That wouldn't be safe, Miss Pember. The road between here and there is alive with Swain's men. He'd like nothing better than to get hold of you.
You're not making yourself very clear.
It'd cost your brother a lot of money if he ever got his hands on you.
That's absurd. I'm needed in Yellow Creek, and I'm going there. This is a free country.
It was until men like Swain took it over.
You could take me. You got the money through.
That was different.
I'm going if I have to go alone. Perhaps you're afraid.
I'm afraid, all right, but not for myself.
You're not serious, Miss Betty.
I certainly am.
Do you think she means that?
Yes, sir. She's got a mind of her own.
Miss Pember.
Yes, Grogan?
I couldn't help but overhear what you said back there, and I've been wanting to do something for you ever since you took care of me when I was hurt that time. Maybe I could help you do what you want.
If she still insists on going, the best thing to do is to hire some men. They can take her to Yellow Creek the safest way, by the main road. In the meantime, keep an eye on her.
It's a good idea. I'll watch her.
I'll get in touch with you later.
I'll have your horse saddled and ready tonight after things get quiet.
Don't tell Mr. Sanderson.
Don't worry, I won't.
Thanks, Grogan.
I'm glad to do it, Miss Pember.
Reckon you think you're a pretty smart hombre.
Have you heard Dipper?
Don't, Bert. You promised not to start a fight. Bert and I are on our way to Gold City to be married.
That's your mistake.
Why?
If you think I care.
Remember, you're not back in Yellow Creek yet, Ward.
I'll get back. Anytime I please.
Bert, Pember's sister's heading for Yellow Creek tonight alone. Would Swain like to know that?
He's not the only one.
No, Bert. You promised you were through with all that.
You keep out of this. I'll handle things. Listen, Grogan, I'll tell you what we'll do.
Oh, Ward, just a minute.
The boys wanted me to thank you for bringing that money. That's all right. I was glad to do it. For a lot of reasons. I hear there's some Swain men in town. If you'll point them out, we'll clean them up.
Adler, work!
Miss Pember has disappeared. Is her horse gone? I never thought of that. Let's look in the barn.
Miss Betty may be in the hotel.
Let me go!
Molly, you stay out of this!
Stop it!
I'm all right, Ward. Where's Miss Betty?
Molly, what happened?
Bert took Miss Pember.
Sanderson.
I'm all right, Adler. Gilmore just made away with Miss Betty. Ward's after him.
I'll round up the boys and we'll follow him. I'm going to bring him out.
Ward, I'm warning you. Don't try no tricks. Hey, Ward.
Yeah?
There ain't no sense of us gunning for one another. I've got the girl. We'll cut Swain out of it.
Turning Swain down, are you?
Just looking out for myself.
I'll make a deal with you.
What is it?
Molly's here. I'll trade her for Miss Pember.
Nothing doing. The girl I've got's worth more to me. You better get going, Ward.
Don't come in there! So you would you? She means more to you than I do, eh?
Hurt bad, Molly?
No, I'm right, Dan. Just a crease.
Keep her here and lay low. Swain and his gang are headed this way. I'll try and draw them off.
That's that gang from Rockville. Head them off.
Why don't you draw, Swain?
You're the first one that ever beat me to the draw. You shattered my arm, Ward.
I could have killed you just as well, Swain. But I'm keeping my hands clean.
I've waited a long time for this, Swain. Get in there.
It's hard to believe that one man could have done all that. And it's even harder to find words to thank you.
Don't let that worry you. I'm plumb satisfied the way things turned out.
Well, Ward, you sure are a disappointing outlaw.
If it hadn't been for Dan, I wouldn't be here.
If it hadn't been for Adler, maybe none of us would be here. You know, Adler, when I first saw you and your men, I thought you were part of Swain's gang.
The boy just about cleaned them out.
Ain't many more of them left. Ward, I need you. I want you to keep right arm working for me.
Is that a promise?
You bet it's a promise. Now, Betty, you better run along home. Do you think you can make it safely?
I don't know. I think someone ought to go along with me.
How would I do?
He'll keep working for you, all right. Just try and fire him.